Hi guys, welcome to WebSensePro. Welcome to another video. In this video, I'm going to explain in a little detail about robots.txt and the usage of robots.txt in search engine optimization. So a few weeks back, I created a video related to Shopify, which is for beginner level SEO optimization. If you want to learn about SEO and you are a beginner and you don't have any technical knowledge, that video will help you. So this is the video which I'm talking about. I got a lot of good comments and good reviews. So I created another video related to SEO, which is related to robots.txt. Now let's first understand what is robots.txt. This is one of the website which we have for our client, lavishfashions.com. It's a US based client. We develop their clothing store on Shopify. And we also are managing ads and SEO for that client. We have just started working on SEO and client has approved showing their website on the video, by the way. So they haven't stopped us displaying this store to the public. And now let's first visit the robots.txt file. So guys, before we proceed, I want to ask you something. Do you guys think that SEO is hard? Do you think managing that robots.txt, adding code, setting a meta title, meta description, and all of that kind of stuff is hard for you? And it's a little more techy and you don't want to mess up around with that and you want an automated way to handle all of that kind of stuff automatically? You can do that with SEO. And so this app, which I'm showing you guys on my screen right now, is going to automate the whole SEO process for you. It is going to add robots.txt, image alt tags, meta title, meta description, and all that kind of stuff in just one single click. So you don't have to do all of that kind of advanced on-page SEO manually. So if you want to avail this app with 50% discount just for the viewers of this video, you can find the coupon in the description where you will be able to install this app for half of the price. Yes, you heard it right. So automate all of your SEO jiggle and all of that technical stuff which you don't want to mess around with this app, using the code which I'm going to share in the description with the 50% discount. So the regular pricing of this app is down below, which is $29.99 a month for all of the features for ChatGPT AI writer, bulk edit meta tags, on-page SEO scan for 1,000 products, image compress, site speed up, a lot of stuff you will be getting. And you will also have this premium plan with all of these cool stuff mentioned. You will be getting 50% off from this video. Check out the coupon in the description. So make sure to try that out. This app, you can try the free plan. And if you think it's improving your SEO, you can then move on to the pro plan. So definitely try that out. Link in the description. Now let's proceed with the video. So that's how currently a Shopify robots.txt looks like. Now first, let's try to understand what is robots.txt. Robots.txt is going to tell all of the external agents like Google agent or Google bot. Normally they are called bots, Google bots, Bing bot, all of the search engines and all of the tools have their bots working 24/7 to scrape the internet and get information from the different websites so they can feed in their search engine, they can feed in their AI tools and train them basically for the better search results and for the better responses in case of AI. What robots.txt does is that that's the entry points for all of the bots. So if Googlebot is trying to crawl your website, it's going to first come to the robots.txt file and ask the robots.txt file, am I allowed to visit this page or am I not allowed to visit this page? And as you can see here, this user agent, static means that this is for all of the agents, no matter is the Google agent, no matter is the Googlebot, Bing bot or any other bot. Google also have a lot of bots. It's not just for the search. They have Google Ads bot, Google Marketing. There are a lot of different type of bots and they all have different roles. And in this robots.txt, we are explaining that all of the agents should follow this robots.txt file and they should not be scraping the URL which is mentioned here. They are not allowed. They are not allowed to go into /admin. They are not allowed to go in /cart and /orders, /checkouts. And you might be thinking that I don't want bots to stop indexing my cart page. Actually, you should, because that's the dynamic page and the content of this page keeps changing as it's an e-commerce website. And when someone adds product to the cart, for every single customer, it's a different cart page, and you don't want the bots to index every single time when someone adds product to the cart. So it's a dynamic page, and all of the dynamic pages will be in disallowed. So bot is not going to crawl or index those pages. By the way, if you want to prevent your pages to be indexed, disallowing them in robots.txt is one way, but the more strong method is to add a no follow tag. So what is no follow tag? So if you Google no follow tag HTML, and this is basically, let's visit this website, and it says that rel equals to no follow. So this is for the link. If it is a link and it has this rel equals to no follow, meaning this link will not be indexed on the Google search engine or any of the bot. And this is meta name robots. So this is for all of the bots. And when there is content no follow, meaning this page is not allowed to be crawled or indexed, meaning if I'll have this meta tag on my page source code, it is not going to be indexed by the search engines. Currently, if I go to lavishfashions.com and open the source, so view page source, and you will find that it will have do follow. So if I search for follow, it should have do follow showing up. Meta name robots. So let's search for meta name robots. Okay, it doesn't have that, meaning by default, every single bot is allowed to index this page. If I had no follow mentioned here, like this one here, so copyright, and it says rel equals to no follow, meaning this link which is showing up is not allowed to be followed. It's a no follow link. So pages or search engine do not need to follow this page. Similarly, if I had this meta name robots content is equal to no follow tag on my page, then it is not allowed to be indexed. So how you can stop the bots to make sure your page is not indexed? Mostly you don't want that, but in some cases you want that when you are internally working on the page and you don't want search engines to get that page indexed. And let me show you how you can disable the index for the search engine for the specific page in the Shopify. Now let's suppose there is a product on this store which you don't want Google, Bing, or any of the search engine to get indexed. And let me take it as an example. So that's the product, and I'm currently working on that product. I'm changing the image, and I don't want Google to instantly index that product, or maybe this is a test product. Now how will you stop and add the meta, which is this one here, meta name robots content no follow, on any of the specific product page or any page? Let me show you how you can do that. So if you go to your Shopify backend, click on online store, and then click on these three small dots, and then click on edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to have a backup of your theme in case you mess up anything. You can easily revert it back. It's safe to make any code changes before, make sure to have a backup before making any code changes. So let's click on edit code. And I'm going to go to theme.liquid file. So that's my theme.liquid file. And now I am going to add an if condition here. If product.handle equals to, then I want to add something, do something. So Shopify will check if the product handle equals to this. Now I'm going to copy the product handle. What's the product handle? This is my product handle. I'm going to copy this handle from here and then paste it here. So first Shopify lands on themes.liquid file and check if this product handle is matching. If this condition is true, then it is going to add the code which is present in between this if condition. And I'm going to copy this robots, which is telling all of the bots of Google, Bing, whatever the bot is, that no follow, please don't follow this page. Now I'm going to hit save. And if I now go to the source of the page, so if I open this and click on view page source. And currently you can see that it does not have no follow. It's on this link here, which we previously checked, but it is not on the page, right? I'm gonna hit refresh a few more times in order to make my code work, because it takes some time when you hit save. It's gonna take some time because it's being cached. So I'm gonna open this source on a new tab to show you guys. And here you can see now that meta name robots no follow has been added on this page, right? Now if I check on any of other product, let's suppose if we go to this signature belt here and click on this product and open up this product, view page source of the product, you can see that we do not have content equals to no follow. Here, we just have it on this product page because we have specifically mentioned that if you find this product handle, add the no follow. So this is one way to disable the index for specific product. Now, if you're doing the same thing with the page, all you have to do is just click on this product and replace it with page. So I am just going to add page.handle here and then add my page handle. So let's suppose I'm doing this for the contact us page. Let me copy the contact us page handle. I'm gonna go to contact us page. So that's my contact page handle. I'm gonna copy this and then paste it here and then click save. Now it is going to check if the page handle is matching this. It is going to add this no follow meta to that page. Now let's go to contact page, hit refresh few times, and then check the source of the page. And now you can see we have this meta name robots no follow, meaning it's telling all of the bots that please do not follow this page. This is how you can disable the indexing for all of the bots of the search engine. You should also add that in disallow, but it is the less recommended way on if you want to stop indexing for any specific page. This is mostly used for the dynamic pages or for the complete folders. So let's suppose you don't want the blogs to be disallowed, right? You should not have this disallow. Now, this is for the nudge agent. There are multiple agents which you can see we have here. And this is one. This one is Ahrefs, and this is for MJ12 bots. So these are all different bots where we are telling all of the bots that please do not index these pages, or please do not crawl these pages where it has this disallow. Now we also have this sitemap, which tells the bot that this is my sitemap and you will find all of the pages. Now what if you want to edit this robots.txt file? It's super simple. You can simply go to templates and then click on add a new template in your code editor. First, let's remove this because I don't want any index to be stopped. So I'm going to save this after removing this meta no follow. And I am going to add a new template for my robots.txt file by clicking on add a new template. And from here, click select template type and click on robots.txt. After clicking on that, click on done. And here we have our robots.txt where you can add your own rules, your own user agent rules. By default, you don't need to change anything within robots.txt file, but if you want to add an allow for any specific agent, now let's try adding an allow for the user agent. So I'm just gonna copy this here and paste it on bottom of my file and allow my blog page and then click save. Again, it's gonna take few seconds in order to update the robots.txt file. So let's wait for it and hit refresh. Now you can see that we have this new rule added, which is basically telling all of the bots that you are allowed to go to blog page and scrape the content and index those pages, right? So that's what I wanted to explain related to robots.txt. I hope now it's understandable for you guys how to create your own robots.txt file and how to read the robots.txt file. Let me know if you want me to create more SEO tutorials for Shopify, which will help you get better ranking. If you are new to this channel, I have been creating a lot of tutorials related to Shopify, and we have a lot of free section on our Shopify channel, on our YouTube channel, where you will find a lot of free sections available. And let me show you the sections which we have created. So if you are new to this channel, make sure to subscribe the channel, which will give you a lot of free resources in order to improve the UI of your store. Now, if I go to this development store here, you can see we have this transparent header and we have a lot of free sections available. Make sure to subscribe this channel and let me know in the comments below if you want me to create more SEO tutorial for Shopify. Until next video, have a great day.